Now, here are some local corporate headlines. SM Investments posts a 30% rise in its nine-month bottom line to nearly 56 billion pesos. The C-led company cites buoyant consumer activity in malls and sustained spending discretionary retail categories. But it notes it will continue to monitor the impact of food prices and interest rates on spending. Meanwhile, Ayala Land grows its third quarter net income by 33% to 7 billion pesos. This brings its nine-month bottom line up 38%. The company says lower costs had offset its flattish revenue. As for San Miguel Food and Beverage, it reports a 6% increase in its nine-month revenue. This as its beer business posted a 9% growth in consolidated sales, while its spirits division up 13% due to strategic pricing and promos. SMFB's food business remained steady amid inflationary pressures, but anticipates cost benefits from declining raw material prices. Meanwhile, ICTSI posts a flat bottom line in the third quarter, bringing its net income to $484 million, up just 4% year-on-year. The Razon-led firm attributes this to higher operating interest income and lower COVID-related expenses. It cites contributions to Manila North Harbor Port and new services at terminals in Davao City, Pakistan, and Indonesia. And finally, Taiwanese e-vehicle maker Gogoro opens its first international flagship center in Makati City. The company will put up its e-scooters up for sale for its commercial launch next month. The firm currently has 5 battery swap and go stations in Metro Manila, with plans to put up 30 more next year. Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Marks & Spencer after its first half profit smashed forecasts. The news sent the British retailer's stock soaring. It's currently trading nearly 10% higher. Also in focus, shares of Adidas after it announced that it will cut inventory levels more than expected. Shares of the sportswear giant are trading lower by over 1%. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of eBay. The company said it expects holiday sales to come in below expectations. Shares of the e-commerce firm plunged over 7.5% in pre-market trade.
On European markets first, they're trading on a mixed note amid a barrage of earnings reports. Data showing retail sales in the Eurozone fell in September, also weighing on sentiment and further highlighting the prospect of recession. As for Wall Street, futures are flat as investors are seen staying on the sidelines ahead of Federal Reserve Chief Jerome Powell's speech later tonight at the Fed's Research and Statistical Centennial Conference. Asian markets ended Wednesday trade mostly lower. This is as investors in the region also stayed cautious ahead of Fed Chief Jerome Powell's speech. Japan's Nikkei 225 shed a third of a percent, even as the Reuters Sankan survey showed confidence among large Japanese manufacturers rose in November. Some notable stock movements in the region. The Hong Kong listed shares of Chinese conglomerate Ping An tumbled 5.4%, wiping out almost $2.1 billion in market capitalization. This is on reports Chinese authorities had asked the firm to take a controlling stake in troubled developer Country Garden. Country Garden, meanwhile, surged 12% to a one-month high. Now over to Singapore, major telco Singtel saw its stock plunge 4.8%, its biggest daily loss in 3 months. That's after its unit Optus suffered an outage in Australia, leaving millions without internet and disrupting payment systems and train networks. As for the local bourse, it closed higher ahead of the third quarter GDP report on Thursday, but still on anemic volumes.
If we would look at the value turnover, it's still anemic. So, but if we would look at how the market moves, we have a resistance level and support levels being respected. Evidently, we just reached a 6,000 level in the previous weeks, and we're now on this rebound towards a 6,300 level.